Good morning students, welcome to class 3. So today we will start with maths of standard 3. Now first chapter in standard 3 maths is revisiting class 2. What is the meaning of this? This means whatever we have studied in class 2 students, all those important topics, all those important points we will revise in this chapter. Okay? Now, basically, main things that we have learned in class 2 is numbers from 1 to 500. Many of you also know numbers from 1 to 1000, so that is also very good. Then, in class 2, we studied about addition of two numbers, where you are adding two numbers properly. Then in class 2 we studied about subtraction and finally we learnt about multiplication. Okay. Now let us have some small examples for all the four. Suppose I am speaking a number 493. Correct? I am speaking a number 493. What is its after number? What is the meaning of after number, students? The number which comes after that. So what is after number of 493? 494. Correct? Now suppose, students, I take one more number, say 699. Correct? What is the after number of 699? After number of 699 is 700. Okay? Now let us learn about the concept of before number. Suppose I have a number say 900. Correct? Now what is the before number of 900, students? What is the meaning of before number? The number which comes before that. Okay? So what is the before number of 900? It is 899. Correct? Now let us also see one example of a between number. Suppose I am taking 123-125. So this is an example of between number. 123-125. So what will come in the dash? 124. Okay? So this was after, before and between number. Now let us say also revise how we were writing number names. Suppose I am writing 103. Suppose I am writing 299. Suppose I am writing 485. Okay. Now, students, in second standard, we were writing number names. So let us have a quick revision of how we were writing. 103. How we were writing? 100. And 3. Correct? 299. How we are writing? 200 and 99. Okay? Similarly, 485. How we are writing? 400 and 85. Correct? So this how we were writing the number name of numbers. So students, in this very small revision, we have seen concept of after number, before number, between number, and we have also seen concept of what we can say the number names. Okay? Later on in this video, we will also see the concept of ascending and descending. Correct? Fine. Now, let us move to the next point, students. That is of addition. Okay. Now, let me take two general numbers. Say 329 plus 411. I have to add. Correct? So, sir will do this addition once more very, you can say slowly so that you can understand. 9 plus 1, If you know the, you can say method of counting with hand, that you can do. 9 plus 1 is 10. 1 will be carried over. Correct? 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. I again repeat. 9 plus 1, 10. 0 is written. 1 is carried over. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. Correct? And 4 plus 3, you can calculate with your hand. 4 plus 3 will be 7. So this is how this addition actually works. Let us take one more example. Say 685 plus 733. Okay? 685 plus 733. So let us see. 5 plus 3, you can do it on your hands. 5 plus 3 will be 8. Correct? 8 plus 3, calculate on your hand. 8 plus 3 will be what? 11. 11 means 1 will be written here, 1 will be written as a carry. Correct? 7 plus 6, please use your hand, students, to calculate. 7 plus 6 will be what? 1, 3, 13. 13 plus 1 will be 14. Correct? So this is how addition we were doing in second standard. The same type of addition with some bigger numbers will be there in third standard. Okay, so our addition part is also over, students. Now, we will see the next part, that is subtraction part. Let me take some numbers. Say 900 and not 9, we will take a smaller number. 391 minus 228. Okay. Now I hope in second standard we did subtraction properly with the carryover method. If not, we will learn again in third standard. But let us see. 1 minus 8 is not possible. So what we will do? We will borrow 1 from here and this will become 11. And because we borrowed, this will become 8. Now you can calculate in your hand, students, as you are doing. 11 minus 8 is what? 11 minus 8 is 3. Okay. 8 minus 2 is what? Calculate on the hand. 8 minus 2 is 6. And 3 minus 1 will be 1. Correct? Sir is repeating this sum once more so that you can see it very carefully. 9, 1. 1 minus 8 is not possible. So we have to borrow 1 from here. So if we are borrowing 1 to here, 9 will become 8. And this will become 11. Correct? 11 minus 8 will be 3. Okay? Now 9 minus 2, calculate in your hand. 8 minus 2 will be 6, and finally 3 minus 2 will be 1. Let us take one more sum, students. Say 468 minus 281. Correct? Let us start. 8 minus 1, calculate in your hand. 8 minus 1 will be 7. Okay, 6 minus 8 is not possible. So we will borrow 1 from here. If we are borrowing 1, this will become 16. Calculate in your hand, student. 16 minus 8 will be 8 and 3 minus 2 will be 1. Okay, so this is how we are doing subtraction. Let us take one more sum. Say 786 minus 422. Correct? This I have taken without the borrow. 6 minus 2, 4. Calculate in your hand. 8 minus 2, 6. And 7 minus 4 is 3. So this is how, students, we were doing subtraction in class 2. Okay? Finally, we will see multiplication. Okay? Let us see small multiplications. 63 into 3. Correct? Let us write one more sum. Say 97 into 4. Correct? And let us write 44 into 5. Now I think students in class 2 at least you know the multiplication tables of 1, 2, 5. If not, use this corona lockdown vacation to make your multiplication tables of 1 to 5 or even 1 to 10 strong. Okay, let us see. 63 into 3 is what? 3 into 3 equal to 9. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9. So 3 into 3 is 9, correct? Now 3 into 6, you can do the multiplication table. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15, and 3 sixes are 18. So our answer will be 189, correct? Let us go for the next one. Now you have to know the table of 4. 4 sevens are, please calculate. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16, 4 fives are 20, 4 sixes are 24, 4 sevens are 28. So 4 sevens are 28, 8 is written here, 2 is written at the top. 4 9s are, if you continue, 4 7s are 28, 4 8s are 32, 4 9s are what? 36. 36 plus 2 will be 38. I will revise this once more. 4 7s are, what is 4 7s are? 4 7s are 28. So 8 is written here, 2 is written at the top. 4 9s are what? 4 9s are 36. 36 plus 2 will be 38. Okay, students. Now we will see the sum of multiplication with 5. 5 4s are, 5 1s are 5, 5 2s are 10, 5 3s are 15, 5 4s are 20. So 5 4s are 20. 0 is written here, 2 is carried over. 5 4s are 20. 20 plus 2 will be 22. Okay, students. So this is how we are doing multiplication. Okay, so till now we revised the concept of after number, before number, between number, number name. Then we revised the concept of addition between two numbers, subtraction between two numbers, and remember, addition we also practiced the method of carryover. Subtraction, we also practice the method of borrow, and finally we saw examples of multiplication. Okay, now we will see certain sums based on what you can maybe bill generation, maybe ascending and descending, or maybe some fun with numbers. So that part will be in the next video. So you can see this video once more, students. Thank you and have a nice day.